Hello, and welcome to the Albright Scholar for September 2024. My name is John Pankratz. I teach history at Albright, and each month it's my privilege to welcome BCTV viewers and residents of Greater Reading to take a glimpse inside our learning community up on North 13th Street, to look at the work being done by teachers and students, and to think about its impact on all of us. Well, a school year has begun for everybody, right? It's September, and our year is off to a really wonderful start. My custom here on the Albright Scholar is to make announcements, to talk about that impact on all of my viewers. And today we're going to be talking about a new school at Albright, a new umbrella, a new big tent that includes some programs that I think you'll find very interesting. Last week I went to the inauguration, the opening of Albright's School of Business and Professional Studies. And I'm really delighted to welcome the inaugural dean of that school, Dr. Lisa Wilder, who's here on my left. Next to her is Goddess Wiggins, a senior business digital media major. And next to her is Matt Bieber, who's a professor of marketing in our School of Business and Professional Studies. It sounds like a big title, and it is really a big tent, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. You know, our goal was really to open the door widely and bring together programs that were all addressing student and faculty needs that spanned our many different areas of business that are within it, mm-hmm. Our new athletic leadership program, which is speaking very strongly to our sports management majors as well as coaches, and to bring in also our online students and graduate students. So pulling all the different ways that you can prepare for these types of careers into one umbrella was really the primary goal of establishing a school and devoting the resources towards those aims. We know that while we're a liberal arts institution, what employers really want are a lot of the skills that you find mm-hmm. in a mm-hmm. business environment. So communication skills, teamwork skills, problem solving, analytical and data skills. And in that way, between our full major and co-major, we can really reach a broad audience of students as well as the broader community.
Right. And it's a whole range of different degrees you can prepare in this school, right? You can have a Bachelor of Science in Business, but all the various other fields of business and some of these specialty tracks as well.
Yeah, so that's one of the things that's been somewhat unique at Albright for many different years, mm-hmm. that we bring and recognize that all business majors need to have a foundation in accounting, in business right. law, in all these fundamental areas, and then we divide up from there into different tracks that really prepare students for their interests, whatever they may be. Our largest track right now is actually sports management, and students bring mm-hmm. that passion for athletics and at the same time build on a foundation of other business skills that go with it. We have a very unique program in entertainment management that builds on the strong arts foundation of Albright and again instills those basic business fundamentals along with a specialty area where our students can go out and compete not just with business majors but also those who have a background in entertainment, law, and so mm-hmm. forth. Mm-hmm. And now within the school, we have different modes of learning that we really wanted to address. And that yes. was an important part of what this is, that in today's society, students are looking for a lot of flexibility and technology has advanced to meet that need for flexibility.
Right.
So for that reason, our students at the bachelor or the graduate level can actually study 100% online if that is the degree method that works best for them. Okay. including fully asynchronous options that you can meet with the class if that works for you. But if your child's soccer championship was that night,
you're not
penalized because we have the technology that can bring that class to you in your home in the most flexible ways possible.
Boy, that really is a welcoming thing. And when I talked about the impact on folks in Berks County, that really makes it a live option for them.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you can pursue an undergraduate degree, but also a master's of science.
Yes, that's correct. So in the business, we have undergraduate degrees in pretty much all the fields. So management, marketing, sports management are very popular. Our students in finance have a variety of options. They can actually specialize in finance with a business focus, or they can actually add more accounting and economics than the typical finance graduate. And that's been something out in the marketplace. We see the high-level internships those students are achieving and their employment outcomes with that combination. So you can do that at a bachelor's degree, either online or in person. And then we're offering a Master of Science in Business as well. A lot of MBAs in the past were a little smidgen of everything in business, especially aimed at non-business backgrounds. What we find are students, there's so many, I mean, 25% of our students alone, nationally about 30% of students are graduating with a bachelor's in business. We take that now to prepare students for the really high value, high demand fields, data analytics, digital marketing. We are opening this spring a major in healthcare administration, inclusive and ethical leadership that focuses on things like diversity and workplace ethics and positive work environments. So all those are specialties that you can do now at the master's degree level with 10 courses for a full degree or just 4 for a graduate certificate. You can walk out in 5 months with a certificate in those fields that prepares you for whatever you're looking for, whether it's a full master's degree or just waiting in for some more specialized training. Marketing's moving ahead very fast. We have faculty can help you move ahead fast with it with a 5-month program.
That's really flexible and really attractive for someone who doesn't necessarily need a master's degree, but they want that, concentration of 4 courses, and they can
walk away with a graduate certificate.
Something really, really useful. Great. Well, Goddess, I know that you're not doing the grad program yet, but you enrolled in Albright before this entire school came together. But you're now in your senior year, interested in business, interested in marketing, interested in digital media as well, and you came to Albright interested that way, right?
Yes. So I started off in a different major, but then I transferred over to marketing. That was the best decision I ever made. I had my own business. So just being in marketing, I didn't know the business that I was getting into when I started my business at 16. So marketing was just like a huge field, and I met my mentor, Professor Bieber. I made him my mentor.
Exactly.
I never said yes to this arrangement.
but it actually changed my perspective on my business because I am a graphic designer. I have a freelance business. So I knew about the creativity side, but I never knew about the marketing and the business side. So this actually helped me.
Oh, I bet it did. Some actual practical science of business of doing that.
Yes.
Has this been gratifying for you, Matt?
Absolutely. So I say this, and I mean this. Teaching is the hardest job I've ever had in my entire life. It's also the most rewarding. We're in the business of helping to transition young individuals from one stage in their lives to the next stage in their lives.
Yep.
And seeing that growth is amazing. I remember the first time I met Goddess in class, and did not know what to expect or where she was going. But she is now a perfect example of what the School of Business at Albright, what types of students we can produce, what types of students we can turn out to get the world ready, so that they can get the world ready for where we're going next.
Yeah.
It's what she's learning in the School of Business that gives her resilience, adaptability, and the power to do really whatever she wants when she gets that degree in her hand.
That really is so crucial, resilience, because we're living in a world that's changing every day, right? Lisa just came from a meeting, who knows? It's both exciting, but also scary. And I think understanding change, knowing how to apply the skills that you're gaining, but also knowing how to learn new skills if you need to.
Yes.
Wow.
And I really like the broad perspective that Albright has always embraced.
Always.
That a large proportion of students at Albright will have a combined major, so that you don't have to be just one thing. You're coming in, getting a foundation as an educated college student, but also developing multiple ways of thinking The School of Business and Professional Studies incorporates also our Department of Government and Public Policy.
Yes.
So that's a recognition that these things are really...
There are about 17 colleagues we could have invited on the show.
Exactly, exactly. And they're doing amazing things there. And we'll have a student who's majoring in international business and international relations. And what a better skill set to walk into a complex global environment where you're gonna have government regulation, you're gonna have very complicated, different information coming into you from the economics point of view and business, and really having that more holistic view is one of the things I really like about this path that our students take, whether they're doing it inside the classroom, outside of the classroom, with the activities they pursue, and then to make this co-major where that you don't have to choose just one thing.
Right.
You know, one of our biggest combined majors is with our music industry studies program. So going out with a business degree like that meets the accreditation standards of our peers, and at the same time being able to also offer those specialized courses that are going to prepare you for a particular industry or a particular interest. We have history in business majors.
Yes, we do.
Which gets you ready for a variety of different things. Working with a student with an interest in historical fashion, well, Albright can bring that together.
Yes.
And that's one thing that we want to be a part of, and therefore the School of Business programs are not isolated from the rest of the college.
Right.
And in fact, the co-major, again, is one of the distinctive characteristics of our education.
I agree. It's and I've seen so many wonderful combinations of curricula that students have pursued. Goddess, tell us a little bit about a favorite class that you've had within the School of Business.
One of my favorite classes is I think I don't even have a favorite class. I think just the whole marketing department is just like every class that I took in marketing was like just so helpful for my business.
Okay.
In every aspect.
Yeah, that you have particular goals you're trying to achieve, and literally every chapter, every class speaks to those goals.
Yes, especially like every faculty member in the School of Business, like if I go in the office and I tell them something that I'm actually going through with my business, they say, okay, what's your goal, what's your plan, okay, how can we help you?
Yeah.
I think that's the best thing about it, especially if you're coming in as a freshman and you have like a business that you want to like pursue after college. Everybody says, what's your goals, what's your plan? They're going to help you achieve that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Matt, I know that in marketing you do a lot of hands-on work in most of your classes. Give us a few examples of that hands-on education.
Sure. So I know from talking to people in the industry what they're looking for in marketing graduates is day one ready.
Yeah.
And that's a lofty expectation. Maybe they're not quite day one ready, but could we have them day 30 ready, day 31 ready? And to do that, especially in my field, we need to get students hands-on experience. So when it comes to my classes, I have really four tent poles that I build my classes around. One is experiential learning.
Mm-hmm.
Two is I integrate industry certificates such as Google Analytics, Google Ads, Hootsuite, HubSpot. I integrate those into my courses. The third is high value.
I can just see those listed on somebody's resume. Mm-hmm. Do you know how to use this application and this software? Yes, yes, yes.
Correct. And then the third is high value guest speakers. So I bring in experts from the industry as well as Albright grads working in the industry, because I believe I'm doing my students a disservice if I'm the only voice that they're hearing in the classroom.
Right.
And fourth, and this goes to what you just mentioned about this is going to look good on your resume or look good on your LinkedIn profile, I'm helping them create social proof. I'm helping them create, by their sophomore year, junior year, at the latest senior year, evidence that they can do the job that we're preparing them to do, that employers can trust the quality of the graduate that our School of Business is putting out. If you have your Google Analytics certification, if you have your Google Ads certification, doesn't necessarily tell an employer that you can do that on day one, but it does signal to them that you're someone that they can work with and they can shape and they can get you into the shape that you need to work for them. And so really what I'm doing in my classes is trying to give those signals, help students gain those signals that tells the workforce that they're day one ready.
Right, and it instills the kind of mindset in that students that self-presentation and relating to the marketplace out there is their job. It's not 4 years of study and then let's see how that works out. It's 4 years of preparation for the market.
Correct, and to do that, you know, we could just do a contained in-house marketing project where students don't step outside the classroom. To the greatest extent possible, I try not to do that. I try to get students out working with real clients. Yeah. So visit West Reading, Fighters Heaven. Right now we're working with a small business in Schuylkill County. We're doing Google Analytics audits for them. I am trying to get students hands-on experience, and the students that get it, they get it. They know what this experience means. They know that they're getting the opportunity to make mistakes in a safe environment, because I'm not going to fire them, right?
Right.
They might get a little lower of their grade, but I'm not going to fire them. So they can make mistakes, they can grow. So when they get their first real assignment, when they're out of college, in their job, they know what they can do. They've already done this, they've already seen this, and now it's just applying it.
Great, great.
And I'd like to emphasize, too, that it's easier to do that in a face-to-face environment, but Matt's actually also brought that into our online classes as well.
Okay.
So our online graduate courses, in many cases, are also working with clients. They're having those client meetings. They're working together in teams in all of our classes that they have things that they do that are bringing them together. So this is in no way an online correspondence course. This is a highly interactive, immersive experience at the graduate level, too, with certificates embedded in the program, with clients embedded in the programs and so forth, you know, helping them to apply what they're learning in the classroom to what they're currently doing on at work, as well as working in these new environments as well. So once again, even at the graduate level, it's about hands-on learning. It's about implementing the things that you've been exposed to, as you say, in a safe sort of playground where you're able to build that experience and talk about it. In the accounting and finance area, we see students pulling internship experience as well into that. Mm-hmm, we do tax preparation. You know, these sorts of hands-on, they're a service to the community, they're a service to employers. They get a chance to really work with these students, and job offers often follow right afterwards.
Right, because they know they can do.
And our students understand what that job actually entails. And those internship experiences and the embedded classroom clients really give a student a chance to customize their environment, their education, to prepare themselves for the career that they've discovered they really like. Mm-hmm. It's not this aspect of it, it's that. And I want to do more of this because I love it. So, you know, God has brought that business right to us and continues in that way. A lot of students are stumbling into and finding their career path through those embedded experiences.
But they really have a realistic idea of what the future holds for them by their sophomore year, right? They're not just...
Hopefully, yes.
Yeah, hovering. Great. And I think in terms of the online experience, I think students who come at it with... real needs and real projects are better online students as well, because the motivation's coming from them.
Yeah, and that's been such a fulfilling part of working at Albright for all these years. So this is my 24th year.
Yes, it is.
Starting all the way back at assistant professor and now into my current role, making sure that the train runs on the track and everyone is supported with everything they possibly have. So being a full-time administrator gives me a tremendous opportunity to reach back and to support others in helping their education be successful and their work environment as well for faculty to help recruit and to attract and keep those top-notch individuals as guest speakers and faculty members. Of all the times I've worked here, I think one of the more rewarding experiences also has been working within our online programs. So Albright was an innovator early on into the way of taking folks with an incomplete bachelor's degree or someone who needed to change their path, you know, leaving engineering and going into business or whatever it is, and doing so in a way that's adaptable and flexible and works for extremely busy college students who are adult learners. So the School of Business also serves that population as well. So we've consolidated those programs. Again, we've built on both a combination of synchronous and asynchronous, meaning you don't always have to do the meeting at that particular time to build that flexibility, to really support the adult learners that are coming in, and then to have them actually move right into our graduate programs as well, which are fully online. So being able there, you know, you're changing a life, you're changing a direction of an entire family. And in today's really volatile, especially coming out of what we've gone through in the past 5 years in higher ed, there are more what we call them stopouts now. We don't call them dropouts because that's often not the case.
No.
But there are people who had to take a detour. They had to somehow take a break. So we're reaching out to them. Albright has instituted a new transfer policy, which has really opened the door up to those who have an associate's degree, only need one general education course, plus 10 courses at Albright to be able to walk away with their bachelor's degree. We have the interdisciplinary studies degree embedded within the School of Business, which allows you to mold together a degree and complete that thing that might be only 5 courses away. Mm-hmm. But something happened, and we see that happen to so many of our students. And now being able to throw open the door and say, we've got something for you, is one of our main missions. Because again, we know that this translates into social mobility. We know this translates into a distinctive outcome.
Yeah, this is a train you can hop back on.
Exactly.
And it's going someplace. Mm-hmm. Great. Goddess, I know it's always an awkward question for seniors. What does the future hold for you? Are you going to stay in this area? Are you going to back to Philadelphia, or will you be working from Milan?
That's the goal, working from Milan. That's the goal. But I think I'm going to take a little break and just stay in Philadelphia for a little bit. But also I want to connect, because I have LinkedIn. LinkedIn is a project that Professor Bieber had introduced us to, and mm-hmm. it just has a whole world of just like networking events and things like that. So I
yes.
definitely want to go to a lot of networking events and just network my business. My business is called Diosa Marie Customs, and what it is a freelance graphic design business.
Yeah, say that again.
Diosa Marie Customs.
Diosa Marie.
Yes.
Okay.
So it's a freelance graphic design business which helps other small businesses increase their marketing in a department. Mm-hmm. So basically, what I want to do in the future is just travel the world and mm-hmm. help other small businesses expand a business.
Yeah. To get the word out.
Yes.
All their individual words out.
Yes. I love building brands from the ground up instead of just going to a big brand and then, you know, just trying to slide into their marketing department. I think that building up a small business and also having like the things that they want and just putting it together, I think it'll just become a beautiful creation.
Yeah. And you know, one of the questions of the 21st century is, are people going to find satisfying work? And I think working at that scale in a small business where you feel the ownership, you feel the responsibility, and you feel that your personality is being expressed.
It's like your personal baby. You're just growing.
Yeah.
Just growing and
yeah.
growing.
We love it. We love it like our children.
Yes.
Yeah. And sometimes they succeed and sometimes not.
I mean, failure is also a good thing, too, because now you know what to work on.
Yeah. No, it's a learning experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'd like to add on to this. So Goddess mentioned the immersive LinkedIn. It's a semester-long project helping students develop social proof early on in their college career mm-hmm. so that they have a leg up before they get to the job market. I'm not going to take credit for Goddess's business. She had that business
yeah.
before my project. But I like to think that I helped her find a new avenue to promote herself.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you were skeptical at first because your profile was your business name.
Yeah.
And I said, Goddess, we're going to promote you as an individual, and mm-hmm. through you, you can grow your business. But the reason that I wanted to go back to this, and it's another thing that I love about Albright, we're trying to help students live their best personal and professional lives. And there's absolutely an intersection of this.
Yeah.
And students like Goddess, who have found value in what we do, they give back.
Mm-hmm.
So what I do now with my LinkedIn project is I actually have students who found success in the project kick off the project to the next group of students.
Perfect.
So Goddess, as a sophomore, junior, I'm not even sure when you first came in, she started coming in and being a guest speaker in one of my classes, because she brought value to the classroom and she could connect more easily with those students
right,
than
and
I
they
could.
With her.
So I want to give her a special shout out mm-hmm. because I think she's selling herself a little bit short in everything that she's done and got out of it. And I do know if it's Milan, Philly, wherever it is, she is going to be incredibly successful.
That's my guess as well. Yeah, yeah. That's why I'm glad
Thank
you're
you.
Out here on the show. I think there's going to be a LinkedIn workshop towards the end of this month?
So I heard that you've been recruited.
I think you've got a low-priced professional photographer who's going to do some pictures for people.
Yes, I believe October 28th for most Albright students, I believe.
So, yeah, I'm looking forward to that. That'll be a great thing. And Lisa, you're now a full-time administrator, and I think you're going to be great in this role. You've also been just an outstanding teacher at Albright, just in terms of the buzz, but then also in terms of the awards that you won for outstanding teaching. Is being a dean still being a teacher?
It is. Well, I'm lucky this semester that I'm back in the classroom with one class.
Good. Nice.
And actually, I was really happy that that worked out because it's really helping me to stay in tune with the flow of the semester, the things that are on the students' mind and on the faculty's mind, and being able to be rooted in supporting them and what they're doing. But I was a department chair for multiple terms, which means I felt like I was administering and supporting the department on the weekends, late at night, in the tiny little places I could squeeze around my teaching. I've always been involved in our online program. So what I see now is an opportunity to recognize the needs that are there and then just remove all the landmines and all the things that are going to hold back these students and faculty from doing their absolute best. And really opening new doors. So again, building on the connections that I have in the local community, the connections that I have within the school as a whole, to promote a school of business, but a school of business and professional studies that's really in an Albright way that brings in lots of different connections to different ways of applying the same sorts of skills. So I feel like it's a really unique opportunity for me to take something that I've known and loved for my entire career almost, and now support it in a way that's going to continue to make it grow and get stronger.
I think we have so much to look forward to. We're grateful that you've taken on that leadership responsibility. We're grateful for the hands-on work that you're doing, Matt, and Goddess, we're already proud of you, and we'll look forward to all that you achieve going forward.
Thank you.
This has been a great show. Thank you for joining us. We'll be back with when the weather's a little cooler in the month of October for another edition of the Albright Scholar. So long.